Hey you guys, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a video of me staining the handrails in my stairwell. I wanted this for a very long time because we have the oak look in our home. That's what, when we purchased the home, this is what we had, is oak cabinets, oak handrails, and we've decided to go ahead and change those over to more of a darker wood look. We didn't want to paint them because we love that grain look still. So we decided to keep the grain and stain them because our floors, as I showed in the previous videos, our floors were redone. We removed the carpet and now we have hardwood. So if you want to see how the hardwood look, definitely go over to the living room tour and you'll be able to see those floors. This video, I'm gonna try my best to talk you through as many tips that I can give. I am not a professional. I would consider myself a DIYer. So I'm gonna give a couple of tips that I've done to obtain the look on the stairwell. So this here is the railing. And this is the oak that I was speaking about. It's very, very nice. It was in great condition, although this is a fixer-upper. And we wanted something a little bit darker. So this right here is the wood look that I was speaking about, the grain, like the wood grain in the handrails. So this is how it looks before. Excuse me if it's like ringing. But this is the before. So here's my little setup. I just got a drop cloth. And so I went ahead and went with the mini wax. It's a poly shade. So basically that has your stain and your polyurethane already in one step. So I went ahead and went with the classic black. We love shiny things, so we decided to go with a glossy color. Now I did look at the satin color as well, and it's beautiful. It's very, very beautiful, but we decided to go with the glossy color. This shade, the black one, it seems to me that with this you can really get two coats and it'll give you the color that you need. Now I did go with the mini wax in espresso. It was beautiful, but it gave me more of a brownish red, and the red is what threw me off, like maybe like a red wood. So I decided to go over it with the black, and the areas that I hadn't painted already, I decided to go in with the classic black. So one thing I did try, I tried using these little brushes. That was the first thing I used. These are absolutely horrible to use. I know I've seen a couple of people say that recommended these. I would not use these unless I'm using these on the corners. It felt like I didn't have that much control over the stain. Now, I went back to Lowe's and I purchased this little sponge, and it is soft. This cotton pad that I purchased, it was like $2 and some change. This was the best investment for this project. It makes it go on so smoothly. You have a bunch of control if you go with this type pad. And then you don't have a bunch of clump and running type stain. When I was doing the brushes, this right here, it was horrible. It was running everywhere. It was everywhere. Luckily with the poly shade, the way you get it off, you can use a paint thinner to remove the stain if it drops anywhere. So, but with this little pad thing, you definitely don't need paint thinner because you got lots of control with this pad. So I'm just gonna, I didn't bring this on my stairwell because my stairwell is carpet and I hate to kick it over, but I'm just gonna lightly dip it just a little bit just to get it damp. And that's a little piece that I've already done. But you're just, only thing you're gonna do is do a nice stroke up to give it good coverage. And down. And the more you give it a nice stroke, the better it looks. And I come back down the back side. And I had on some little gloves. I better put those back on. But And one thing I do like about this product is a little goes a long way. And we plan on removing these so we could get the back side. But in the meantime, I wanted to go ahead and paint it because I wanted to see how it looks. And when I decided to paint it, I didn't like how the others were that oak color, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do them all. But yeah, so these little corners, like, so yeah, like I was saying before, I can't get it any closer so you guys can see, but you definitely, like, the corners you want to get in, and in those corners you want to get in with that nice spongy little handle brush I showed you in the beginning, and I'll show you guys again. That's for like the corners, like little areas that you can't get to, the little small areas. And you just go in and touch those up. But this little sponge thing is the best to me. And a little goes a long way with the product. So you don't need a lot of product. You can go in and you coat it very nicely. One or two coats is enough. A good coat. Oh, one other thing. This arm rail that I'm working with here, I have already sanded it. What I purchased was some, and I'll leave all the information with the stuff I use in the description bar as well. Now, this is what I'm talking about with the hard to reach areas, like in here. You can, like I tell you, you can get the brush and you can dab, but I take this little cloth and I get in there and I just dab it. Just give it a nice dabbing motion, and then you can kind of rub it out to give it a rub, like a long stroke. And I just tap all in here. We are going to paint our spindles. Now, if you're not gonna paint your spindles, definitely go ahead and tape the portion up top and tape the portion basically down the bottom of these, because when you're getting in here, you may hit it. So definitely tape those out. And what, like I said before, you can use the brushes, but I have more control with these. Somebody suggested them, I tried them, and I felt like it was everywhere. But I'm just going in, like I say, and just giving it a nice little tap. And then for your first coat, I would give it a long stroke, and then tap in areas that you missed. And then your second coat is gonna be like your design coat. It's gonna be like your field coat. And you're gonna actually give it its long strokes and go through lightly. You do not have to do a lot of pressure. This project does not need a lot of pressure. As people told me, it was a lot of work. But it's not. Just take your time and go through, and like I say, areas that you miss, don't glob a bunch of stain on it. If you glob a bunch of stain on it, it's gonna have run marks. That's why I say just take a little blot, and you're just gonna blot it. And then you're gonna dip the stain in it, and then and this is your second coat. You're gonna dip it in the stain, and then you're gonna actually mold it out and give it the lines and the longevity to it that you want. I hope I explained this to you guys the best I could. Like I say, this is a project that's so easy that you can do it yourself. You do not have to always get a contractor to do these little projects. I hope you guys utilize this video. I hope the tutorial gave you a understanding of the strokes and things that you need to use, some tips on the products. And like I said before, if you don't understand something, just put a comment below and I'll be more than happy to answer it the best of my ability, because like I stated before, I'm not nowhere near professional. I just do little DIY things to save money.